Hello everyone, and welcome to the Kohl's Gallery at the Long Island Museum. My name is Alexandria Doria. I am the Assistant Director of Advancement, and I am so pleased to welcome you and introduce you to our 8th annual LAM Arts Members Exhibition, Fragile. Since 2014, LAM Arts has offered our community of visual artists a special membership opportunity with a goal to enhance and support the rich artistic talent on Long Island. Offering space for the annual exhibition of artwork is key to that mission. After the challenges of 2020 that have spilled over into 2021, we were eager to invite our artist members back to the galleries and to give them the opportunity to share their artwork with the community. Over this past year, many of us have felt increasingly vulnerable, but we have still managed to see the fragile beauty that is life. This exhibition, Fragile, was an opportunity for artists to express and share their own interpretation of the theme. A distinctive facet of this exhibition was that the museum provided each artist with a wooden panel that was only 12 inches by 12 inches. Artists were welcome to work in any medium as long as they used the panel and stayed within the parameters. The result is a show that looks uniform in size, but is filled with incredibly unique and creative artwork. In this virtual tour, you will see artwork created by 91 artists, and we'll hear from 3 of those artists who will share their inspiration and process. I hope you enjoy this virtual experience, and I also hope that you will have the opportunity to see it in person at the museum, where it's on view now through December 19th. Thank you and enjoy the exhibition. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. My name is Doug Reyna. I'm a local artist here with a studio on Main Street in Setauka. In talking about this piece that I made for the show, everybody had the same panel to work from. But I thought to myself, well, what could I do to make this piece different? And suddenly it dawned on me, this shape is exactly the same kinds of shapes that I paint my my little cigar box paintings on. In fact, I brought an example. But once I get it to this state, it's perfect to paint, and I like to leave this little paper border around it so it acts like the frame and you just hang it up. In the back of my mind for a long time, I've been thinking, I wonder if I could make these cigar boxes work on bigger canvases, on different shapes. So this was my first attempt at doing it. And I'm so happy with how it came out. I think what influenced me is, of course, you know, I'm still thinking about all this shelter at home, COVID life that we're living. And for a brief moment, I thought, okay, we're getting through it, but of course, it seems like it's not letting us go quite yet. I had done some larger paintings in which I had put a woman in a window. She was much smaller because the rest of the painting had to do with the building and the colors that I chose. But I used that big painting as an influence in this little painting. So what I've been chasing lately in my paintings is, can I look at something that's realistic and do a picture that also sort of works as an abstract design? That the way the planes and the shapes hang together is as interesting as a good abstract is, and yet it's also allowing me to pay homage to, I just can't shake Edward Hopper. I just can't. I mean, so this to me was an Edward Hopper, you know, kind of a vibe. Plus, I also get to simplify, even in this little area, I got to just play with shapes and arrange them in such a way that it was simple and elegant. If you're interested in knowing a little bit more about the technique, I have found that if I can get some broken color to happen, in other words, don't mix the paint so thoroughly that it's just one color. I like to have broken color, paint hitting paint, and I get a lot of good luck with that by using a palette knife. A palette knife for me is really great, especially if I'm painting a wall, which is something that a person with a spackle knife would use. You get similar kinds of torn edges and decaying paint look, and it's pretty nice.
Hi, I'm Eileen Palmer, and I'm very thankful to be here at the Long Island Museum in their Fragile exhibit. This piece of work is called The Glass Ceiling. The inspiration for this piece actually came a long time before the piece was developed. The image of a glass ceiling and the imagery of a butterfly being something that metamorphosizes into, it starts out as a funky little caterpillar and metamorphosizes into something beautiful and strong. It was always in my mind, and it was something as an artist that was itching the back of me, and I wanted to create something to memorialize that kind of a feeling. When I first read the prospectus for Fragile, it gave the artist, it said, okay, these are your parameters. We're going to give you a 12 by 12 birch frame, and that's where your art has to be, your art needs to be done on this. And predominantly, I'm a 3D assemblage mosaic sculptor. I was so inspired by Amanda Gorman's poem, The Hill We Climb. In my head, I took the image of a butterfly, and I tried to make the butterfly somewhat resemble the beautiful outfit that she wore at the inauguration. The pieces of glass have, I've laser etched different segments of her poetry on it. One of the things that I've been doing in my art is including QR codes. In this particular piece, the poetry inspired me. So if you go to the QR code that I've embedded in the piece, you can see maybe a two or three minute YouTube of the presentation, her presentation of her poetry. In this particular piece, I used a lot of yellow glass. I used Mira. I used clear glass. I used, this here is called crash glass. I also use a substance called epoxy sculpt. I'll show you some of the tools that I use in case you've never cut glass. This is a simple glass cutter. This is a nippers. Doing a wing, I would draw that wing out on the piece of glass and follow it with the glass cutter and cut around it. I also have electric tools that will smooth out the edges and cut through glass if it's a particularly intricate size piece. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Patricia Morrison, and I have this painting that I did for the exhibition Fragile. And to me, fragile is the perfect word, because especially with children, you know, their minds and their bodies, and this pandemic. Adults don't really think about what they're saying in front of children, or they try to always shield them. But the kids always know. They always know. So that's why I figured the image of a little girl would be the perfect thing. Did like several sketches of what I wanted. And it was a little difficult trying to get that right image of the little girl. She's thinking, but she's not looking totally scared. So finally, when I decided on which sketch I wanted, I put it on 300-pound watercolor paper, because you don't have to worry about soaking it or anything like that. And then after that, I drew it on with a 2H drawing pencil. And then I dampened the paper itself and the image. And you just let it dry a little bit. And so you sort of look at it on the side just to make sure it's just a little sheen, not much. So then I started layering colors of watercolor in, because to me that would really bring out how delicate children are. So I just wanted to make sure I softened it right. I didn't want any hard edges on her face at all. And as I was looking at it, because I stood back to look at it after I had it finished, originally I was going to have like a partial adult figure with the hands, seeing, you know, taking care of the girl's hair. But I decided that the child is the most focal point, so I cut that away. And I decided I'd do it a collage instead of just letting it sit on just the watercolor paper itself. And I hope people really take away from this. They really need to think before they act around their children. And that's why I did it.
Fragile is generously sponsored by Mary Ellen and Michael Lubinsky. Additional museum support is provided by the New York State Council on the Arts with the support of the Office of the Governor and the New York State Legislature.